Welcome to this .NET MAUI DataGrid tutorial. In this video, I will demonstrate how to group records using the Syncfusion .NET MAUI DataGrid. I will show you how to collapse and expand groups, as well as customize the grouping of records. I opened an existing MAUI application. Here I've already configured the .NET MAUI DataGrid and bound the orders info to the item's source property. To learn how to add the .NET MAUI DataGrid control to your MAUI application, watch the video linked in the YouTube card above or in the description below. Now I run the application. You will see the list of order details has been displayed. Next, I will show you how to group columns based on a specific category. To do this, I define group column descriptions and add the group column description element. I specify the category as country in the column name to group the order details accordingly. Once the application is loaded, you will see that the order details have been grouped by each country. You can also group the data by multiple categories by setting the grouping mode property to multiple. After that, I define another group column description within group column descriptions and specify the column name as city through which the order details will be grouped. As you can see, the order details are categorized based on the country and its respective city names. To expand and collapse the groups, simply set the allow group expand collapse property of the data grid to true. By default, the groups will be in an expanded state. Now you will see an icon that allows you to collapse and expand the groups. Next, I will demonstrate how to customize the indent column. To increase the width, set the value to the indent column width property. By default, it is set to 35. Furthermore, to set background color based on the row type, create a class called CellStyleConverter that implements the iValueConverter interface. To extract the row type for determining the background color, within the convert method, I cast the input value to DataGrid indent cell. I access the parent property and cast it to a data grid row. Then retrieve the data row property of data grid row and convert the row type property to a string. After that, I verify whether the row type is header row. If it is true, return the corbel color to the background. Similarly, assign background color for caption covered row and other row types. In this case, the convertBack method is not implemented, so I return null. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML. Here, I define the resources. Then, let me add the CellStyleConverter class, along with a key. Next, declare a style that applies to all data grid indent cell elements. Within the style, define setter for the background property, dynamically setting its value using data binding. The binding uses a relative source to bind the control itself. After that, a custom value converter is applied, which determines the appropriate background color based on the cell's properties. Now I run the application. You can see the indentation has been applied to each row type along with the background color. You can group the columns by using custom logics to meet the requirements. To do this, create a class called GroupConverter that implements the iValueConverter interface. In the convert method, cast the input value to an orderInfo object. Next, check if the freight property of orderInfo is greater than 0 and less than or equal to 250. If it is true, return the string less than or equal to 250, representing the range for grouping. Similarly, check the conditions for the ranges between 250 and 500 and between 500 and 750. Finally, return the string greater than 1000 to represent the range where freight is greater than 750. The convert back method is not implemented, so I return null. Now I move to the main page XAML. Within the resource dictionary, declare another custom converter named group converter using the local namespace. In the group column descriptions, I modify the column name to freight, as all rows with the same freight value will be grouped together, and specify the value as group converter in the converter to customize the grouping display. Before running the application, I remove the group column descriptions that were used to filter based on the city name. As you can see, the order details are organized based on the freight value. Let's wrap up this video. You have learned how to group freight cards using the Syncfusion .NET MAUI DataGrid. You have also learned how to collapse and expand groups, as well as customize the grouping of records. If you want to see this example's working code, download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI controls. If you found this video helpful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.